G'day, welcome back to the channel. I'm Drew, of course, from Green Grape Productions, and today we're going to do a nice, simple grade, nothing too complicated. Now, you can download this footage if you'd like. There'll be a link below in this YouTube where you can download it for free. You can do whatever you want with the footage. The only thing you can't say is you shot it, but you can put it on your color show reel or anything like that, or you can just practice along. So here we have our footage here. Now, the first thing we're going to do is make sure our color management is correct. Now, I know it's correct, but for the sake of this tutorial, we're going to go down to here, Project Settings, come to color management, and today we're going to be working in DaVinci YRGB color manage, and that's going to give us a really nice starting point, because if we took this off, have it this way, as you can see, our image is really flat. Now, we don't want this. We want to work in a nice color space, so let's go back to here, color manage. Now, there are different ways you can do this, but for today we're just going to do it this way. Alrighty, now the first thing we want to do is have a look at our whites and our blacks. Now, I actually kind of like the color with the white, so I'm going to leave it as it is. Now, with our blacks, I feel like we're just a little bit off. So, come down your qualifier. Now, if you don't see these numbers, just right-click, show picker RGB value. Let's have a look at our darker areas. So, find the darkest point in your image. And as you can see, it's a little bit off. So, let's just push a little bit more blue in there. And a little bit more, we're just using the lift down here, and we're just aiming it towards the color that is least amount. It was blue, so we just put a little bit more blue into lift, so more blue into our shadows to make those numbers a little bit more even to get a nice even black shade, because black is a shade, not a color, of course. Alrighty, so that looks really good. Now we have our first node, so we're just calling it balance. Let's add another node, so Alt S, serial node. Now let's add a little bit more saturation. So come down to saturation, just add a little bit in. There we have, looks really nice. We'll just call this one saturation. Next node, we're gonna call it contrast, spelled incorrectly. Now let's add some more contrast in, or add contrast in. Now we want this image to be slightly dark. So in pivot, we can either go up or down. Obviously going down is making our image brighter. We don't want that. So let's just bring it up. And we'll say about there looks pretty good. So beforehand and after. That's just making a slight difference. New node, so Alt S. So in this node here, we're going to call this one look. We're going to build a nice simple look. It's not going to be a complicated look today. It's just going to be something really easy that you can follow along and learn, and you can apply to other grades. And we're going to do that by using the RGB mixer, which is one of my favorite tools. One that doesn't get spoken about too much, but I think is very good. Alrighty, so in our look node, we're going to start building this golden look. So in our blue, we're just going to bring it right down to around about 25-ish, or exactly 25. Now, as you can see, we already have a nice gold look going on, but we've got a little bit too much green. So in our red output, let's add in some more red. There's looking nice. Now in our green output, we're going to add a little bit more red in. So now we have a nice looking image, but we have a slight problem, and that problem is this window looks awful. Now, all we have to do is come to our power windows here, and we're going to use the old circle power window. I'm going to bring it out. Now, the trick to using power window is to soften them right out, bring it right across, to bring it down a little bit. So here's our image prior to that look. Now, here's our image afterwards. Now, we can make this even better. What we're going to do is just bring down some of this brightness. So in our gain, we're just going to bring it down just a little bit. Like that. To make this image look a lot better than it is, let's make an outside node. So to do this, we want to highlight this node here and press Alt O, which will give us our outside node. Now what we can do in this node is bring some of this exposure down and then just add a little bit more color to this overall image to make it look a lot better. So let's bring some of that gain down, and in the mids, there we go. It's already looking a lot better. Also, what we're going to do is under our blur and sharpen, which is over here, in our blur tool, we're going to bring that up, which blurs out your image. So this is beforehand, and this is afterwards. As you can see, our image is looking a lot better than before. Now what we can also do is bring down the brightness by using our curves. So in our curves, we're just going to bring this one down. We'll say around about there looks pretty good. Nice and simple. Now to keep it really simple, we're just going to add some green into this area here, and we're going to do it using the tint. Just go into your negatives and around about, I'll say there, looks pretty good. Now our power window is getting a little bit weird over here. Let's go back to our look in our power window. Let's bring it in a little bit more to make it more as this lamp is lighting this guy, and even soften it out even more just to get a better looking image. Alrighty, now that's our look for the day. Something that's really easy and simple and just a few little adjustments, and we have this image here. Now, of course, we could further this image if we'd like. We could do some film grain on it. We could change the look completely. There's a lot of different things we could do, but the footage is there for you guys to do whatever you want. Make sure to comment below on the looks that you created, or comment about the projects you're working on. Anyway, thanks for watching. I've been Drew from Green Productions, and have a great day.